there's a lot of hype around the country about micro-credentials, and many people come dipping their toes into the water and saying, what do micro-credentials mean for us? So when the opportunity came forward for Rhode Island educators, we said we really want to truly pilot this across our state and understand what could this look like in the Rhode Island context. We know that there's a great need for authentic professional learning for teachers.
I think at this point in the process, we are trying to sell teachers, for lack of a better term, on the idea of these micro-credentials, because as teachers, we've been through so many things. You know, you want to make it challenging so that they learn and that they grow.
I think it has to intertwine with other things that are happening as much as possible.
One of the things that we're thinking about for our ESSA plan for Rhode Island is to really try to reclaim and redefine professional learning for adults. So what we want to do is we want to change our regulations, our certification regulations, to make ongoing growth and development a part of how people renew their certificate. I think micro-credentialing is one way to help us think about that.
As a district, it would be great to use this as an opportunity to have choice with our professional development. Things that we think are important for us, whether it be a personal goal, a professional goal, a department goal, or a district goal, can all be met by the micro-credentialing opportunities.
If it can be aligned at various levels, whether it's the Department of Education, the unions, definitely the teachers are the most important of all that, but then also embedded into our school improvement plans, our district strategic plans, our accreditation requirements, then I think it becomes a worthwhile thing that is, most importantly, I want to stress, worthwhile in the classroom.
To me, the power and the knowledge is in the room, right? So like in the schools, and that is the potential where if PLCs grow and if we work through these micro-credentialings and we do these validation processes, we're having the conversations that makes teaching and learning better.